Hi, my name is Nelly, and I'm a program manager in the SQL Server product team. And in this video, I'm going to talk to you about HDFS tiering, a new feature that allows you to unify your data lakes. HDFS tiering is Microsoft's latest major contribution to the Apache HDFS open source project, and it's included in SQL Server big data clusters out of the box. Now, if we take a look at the problem that we're trying to solve here, you can see that the amount of data that organizations have to manage today is increasing rapidly. And we realize that keeping all of your data in one single data lake is not always realistic. You may have hot and cold data stores. And in the hybrid cases, you may have data lakes in the cloud and on-premises. Now, HDFS tiering lets you seamlessly unify these different data lakes and then do analytics and machine learning on top of this to gain insights from all of your data. Before we go into how to use HDFS tiering in big data clusters, let's briefly look at SQL Server Big Data Clusters as a platform. SQL Server Big Data Clusters is a complete data platform for analytics and AI with a local HDFS storage as one of its default storages. It's our local data lake. In the big data cluster, you also have access to two different powerful compute engines. We have SQL Server and we have Spark. With HDFS tiering, you can now mount a remote HDFS compatible storage to your local data lake, and you can perform analytics on top of this and query the data seamlessly from Spark and SQL Server. And with the automatic caching capability, reading the remote data is just as performant as if the data was local. As you can see here in this diagram, besides Azure Data Lakes Generation 2 support, we also support mounting other cloud storage solutions. And we're constantly working on expanding this list to integrate with additional HDFS compatible storages out there. Now, if we take a look at how you actually create a mount in the big data cluster, you first need some prerequisites. We first need the credentials to the remote store. In addition to that, we also need a SQL Server big data cluster, and you need the AZ Data command line tool to execute the actual mounting commands. An overview of the actual steps can be seen on this slide. But instead of showing you the slide, let's just look at a demo of how this looks. Here in Azure Data Studio, I have a Python notebook open, and I'm going to use this notebook to demonstrate how you can add a mount to a big data cluster. You can, of course, also run the same AZ Data commands directly from a terminal. Now, the first step is to add your mount credentials. And this is basically a way to be able to authenticate to the remote store. So by setting the mount credentials, we're setting an environment variable in this case, in memory. The next step is for us to log in to our controller endpoints. Once we have done that, we can actually perform the mounting, which is this particular command that you're seeing here. Now, I've already created this mount, but I wanted to explain to you what two different parameters you need to provide when you're creating a mount. First of all, you need to provide a remote URI. It's basically the address to the actual remote mount so that we can find it. The next parameter is a mount path, which is the local path in your big data cluster where you want the mount to appear. And once you've done the actual mounting, you need to check the status to see when the mount is ready. In this case, the mount is ready for usage. So if we browse in the HDFS File Explorer here to the left in Azure Data Studio and navigate to the specific mount path, we should now see the remote files appear as if they were local files in our cluster. Now, to analyze one of these files, I can directly do that from Spark in this case by analyzing it in a notebook and then running the simple query to query the top rows in one of the remote files. Here you can see the results from the query. So basically, we just mounted, and then right after we mounted, we could access the data directly from Spark, in this case, inside the Big Data cluster. Now, let's do the same thing from SQL Server. In the Big Data cluster, I also have my master instance, my SQL Server master instance. And there, I already created an external table over the directory that we just mounted. Now, in order to query the data, I simply have to query the external table, and it's going to read from that particular directory. And now I can join this data with my existing data in the cluster or other data that I've used to virtualize from my Big Data cluster. And I can now do analysis and gain insights from all of my data from my unified data lakes. If you want to learn more about HDFS tiering, you can go to our HDFS tiering docs on our Microsoft website. And if you are curious to learn more about the details of and the implementation of this feature and the actual open source contribution, I encourage you to visit the other links to actually go to the open source submission, the JIRA, and also read research papers that we've written on this topic. Thank you for watching.